I've finally figured it out. Prince must have been singing about acid rain that was blue, because carbonic acid turns litmus paper red. Blue plus red equals purple. If you know what I'm singing about up here, come on, raise your hand. Hey there, pH balance friends. Trace here for DNews. If you were to compare environmental issues to fashion trends, and I mean, why wouldn't you, then acid rain would be the equivalent of bell-bottom jeans. People started talking about it in the 60s, then it slowly infiltrated media and pop culture, and by the mid-1970s, seemingly everyone had an opinion on it. But since then, where did it go? To understand acid rain, you have to understand pH levels. pH means power of hydrogen. Essentially, it measures the kind of hydrogen in a solution. It's not super important to understand how it works, but it ranges from 0 to 14, with 0, battery acid, being the most acidic, and 14, lye, being super alkaline or basic. 7 is neutral. Water is 7. Milk is 6. Seawater is 9. A change in even one number is a big deal because pH is measured logarithmically. One number represents a tenfold change. Okay, so acid rain is bad, you guys, like really bad. It toxifies lakes and streams, destroys forests, and threatens entire plant populations. Acid rain is even harmful to urban environments where it eats away at limestone and marble buildings, all because its pH is crazy. I say crazy because normal rain is acidic, just a little bit. As rain falls from the sky, it picks up carbon dioxide in the air, creating carbonic acid. This gives natural rain a pH of about 6, just slightly on the acid side, similar to urine or saliva. Regular rain becomes acid rain when it picks up not just the carbon dioxide, but sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, which contain much stronger acids. These make their way into our atmosphere when we burn fossil fuels to make energy. Once natural rain picks up this acid, its pH can drop as low as 3. That means that rain goes from pH 6 to pH 3. It's 1,000 times more acidic. 3s are things like citrus, kimchi, or soda. The effects of acid rain entirely depends on where it lands. For instance, if it falls on limestone-rich soil, it doesn't have much of an effect, because limestone is naturally alkaline. It has a pH above 7. So mixing acidity with a lower pH just neutralizes it. In fact, to protect cultivated areas from acid rain damage, limestone can be added to soil as a sort of pH-balancing fertilizer. Though that's pretty much out of the question for huge tracts of land in the wilderness. When acid rain falls on natural or acidic soil or on vegetation, that's when things get bad. Living things have a hard time in acidic environments because the acid basically kills their growth enzymes. Fish can't swim in orange juice. What's more, hydrogen ions in the acid rain replace nutrients in the soil, like calcium and magnesium, which are vital for plant growth. This is why we preserve things in vinegar rather than water, because the acid in the vinegar prevents pickles, or kimchi for all you foodies, from growing mold. Keep in mind that we're talking about ecosystems, so everything is connected. Once acid rain infiltrates soil, it flows into streams and lakes, killing marine life. Even water-dwelling animals that can live in acidic environments, like frogs, still end up dying because the acid kills their food sources. This sort of environmental damage stems as far back as the Industrial Revolution. However, the public didn't really catch wind of it until the 1970s, after it had already caused massive damage, which is why you heard about it. Why you don't anymore is because in the early 1990s, the US government passed a series of regulations that dramatically reduced sulfur dioxide emissions, and acid rain sort of fell off the radar, at least in the US. Acid rain is still an issue in China and Russia, two countries with lots of factories and few environmental regulations. China is particularly bad, as its coal contains higher than normal levels of sulfur. Even parts of Eastern Europe, Canada, and the United States still have rainwater that's just too acidic. And even though our rain will likely never return to a 1960s level of acidity, the effects of this environmental disaster will exist for decades. If you're still mad about acid rain, why don't you make a website and tell people about it? No domain extension will help you tell your story, like a .com or .net domain name. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com's names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. So, acid rain is still a problem, but what about that hole in the ozone layer? Whatever happened to that? You can find out in this video right here. Ozone is 3 oxygen atoms linked together, O3. When in the stratosphere, ozone absorbs harmful UVB radiation, protecting us and other life here on the ground in the troposphere. Should we do a whole video about pH? That's kind of cool, right? Do you have other science questions? Tell us in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get the answers. And thanks for tuning in to DNews.